Hello everybody, it's Katbalu, and I'm here today. I want to talk to you guys about some stuff that I've been thinking about, and I want to share it with you. I'm feeling like I'm in this season of perspective and reflection. And it's not new, because I think that I've been there before. I am often at a place where I'm reflecting and taking in and searching the spirit and just making sure that I'm where I need to be. When I say I'm where I need to be, that means pretty much where I need to be, where I am comfortable and in harmony with oneself. Because it's so easy, and this is just, these are just my opinions, I believe that it's so easy to find a place to fit in, if that makes any sense to anybody. I believe it's easy to find a place to fit in because we can look around and we can see images that we admire or that we like. We can see cliques or people that we're drawn to or people or instances or particulars that we're drawn to or attractive to. And in some way, indirectly, we may begin to pattern, or we can begin to pattern ourselves, our mannerisms, our ideals with the things that we like. So when I say that it's easy to fit in, to find a place to fit in, we generally tend to gravitate to the things that we're comfortable with, that we like, that make us feel good, that you know, embrace us and welcome us. And it's, you know, it's something that's kind of a normal reaction, I think. But for me, and my husband would agree with you, I tend to find myself opposite of that. I tend to find myself often on the outside of the box. And the reason that is because I don't like being in a box. I don't like the idea of conforming and fitting in. And it's not because I'm a rebel. It's not because I want to be different or because I'm a renegade. It has nothing to do with any of that, because I'm a person of order. I truly believe that there is a place and a timing, and we ought to be able to follow and subordinate ourselves and all of that. I don't have any problem with that. I can follow rules. I can accept instruction. I have no problem with that. But what I mean is fitting into someone else's idea of what is good and what is acceptable. And for me, I've always, or at least as long as I can remember, I've always found that I've needed to define my own self, if that makes any sense. I know that I need to define me for me, because in the past, when I've tried to make me who you wanted me to be, or if I tried to look like you thought I needed to look to be presentable or to be acceptable, I failed. And it wasn't that I failed in the view of the world. I failed in terms of not living up to my standard, or not pleasing me. That even goes back to why I lock my hair. It's an indirect way that I can make my point. You know, when I decided to lock my hair some 10 years ago, it was not embraced in all circles. Those that were close to me were like, ugh, why you want to do that? This, that, and the other. It won't go well for your work. There were all sorts of reasons why I shouldn't. And I did it because I wanted to do it. It was in my spirit to do so. I felt the need to do it. And if you're really interested in knowing more about it, I do have a video where I really explain why it was such of importance and so significant for me to do that. But in essence, what I really mean is that, or what I'm really trying to get across is that I think it's so important to find you and find a place where you fit in, where you're happy for you, and where you went, and that harmony and balance can be in your spirit, that you can find that center and be content with it. And I guess I'm thinking about this today. I've been thinking about it today. There's often instances where I find myself, and I find others trying to conform me. At least that's what I think. Draw me in to their idea of what it should be, or make me see it their way. And that's interesting. It's interesting because oftentimes I don't think people mean anything bad by it. In fact, they may have good reasons for doing it. I'm sharing this because I think it's so important for individuals to know that because we are spiritual beings, because we are God's creation, made in the image of God, His workmanship, we are, how can I say it? He has not made any of us robots. Each one of us has a free will. Each one of us has a gift and a purpose and something very unique that is our contribution to this world, and that we can do well. And whatever that thing is for you, that is for you to define, for you to find, I'm still working out mine. And it's fun. I think that's why I got on this thought, you know, because I'm thinking and I'm in this chapter and this season in my life where I'm really feeling like new, like a new bloomer, a late bloomer, but new. And it's exciting for me because I feel like I'm the only one excited about this thing. And it feels good to be challenging myself in a new way and putting some other things on my plate. And I'm enjoying that. And while I'm at a later stage in my life, I'm not so old or I'm not so seasoned that I've missed the bus and I can't learn anymore. But I'm at this place where I have made peace with some things, and I have some closure in some areas of my life, but yet God is still unfolding and opening up and doing new things for these eyes to see. And even while I'm so determined in that, determined to be successful in the thing that I feel God has called me to, determined to pursue the path that I'm on, at times, if not careful, you can become uncertain. I can become uncertain because I am allowing, or if I allow others to say, this is what I think you should be doing, or why didn't you do it this way, or you don't need to do this, or I would have done it this way, you know, all sorts of things. And I there's so many things that I could add on to that I could have, should have, would have did. But you know, it's a season of where you can be, for me, I'm thinking in my introspection, in my perspective of my life, being determined, full of purpose and plan and excited for what the end's going to bring, with the promise in my mind, realizing that God said in His Word that He that has started a good work in you, He will perfect it until the end. You know, so I'm excited about that promise. God said it. So I know without a doubt I'm called. I know that there's purpose. I know there's plan. I'm connected to the vine, secure in the faith with that. So when you and I are like that, when we can feel certain and have that blessed assurance, we really should be okay with being who we are. Where God has called us to be, even if it means sometime walking alone. That's what I mean to say. Took a long time to say it, but that's what I mean to say. So my challenge today, or my question today, is how do you feel about that? I want to hear, if you take the time to watch the video, I want to hear what you have to say about it. It's important to me because I want to hear what sisters are feeling about these things, how sisters are feeling about where they are in their life. And when you take a moment and search within and reflect on your life, decisions, purpose, plan, how do you feel about that? Are you on the path where you need to be? Are you content with where you are or where you're trying to go? Or are you still fitting in a box? Are you still trying to be, fit the mold that someone has told you you should be? Or are you, you know, wearing so many hats that you don't know which one to wear on what day? Whatever that might mean. I just want to hear from you. So if you'd be so kind to share with me, let Katbalu let me know what you're thinking. I want to hear from you. I just love sharing. So thank you so much for watching. And until the next video, be good to yourselves and be good to others. Bye.